Hello, welcome to Noble Architects Consult. Are your Revit models looking flat and lifeless? What if you could turn them into stunning photorealistic visuals without leaving Revit? In this video, I'm walking you through a step-by-step rendering guide that will take your design from dull to dazzling. Whether you are a beginner or brushing up your skills, you are in the right place. Let's bring your model to life. The first thing you need to do is to prepare your model. We've done that already. Now the second thing is to choose a camera view. Open the ground floor plan. Click the drop down arrow close to the 3D view. Open camera. Place the camera at any angle of your choice and pick the view like this. You can extend the crop section to have a better view of it. Now go to visual style, change to realistic. For us to have a realistic view, we need to add environments like the trees, maybe cars, and the rest. Those ones will be placed at the site. Click on site. You can download some trees in revitcity.com if you don't have much in your Revit library. To place the trees, click components, load family. Here is where you will select the folder. Okay, let me place this. I will have to edit this plant. If you are using RPC shrub, you can change it to any plant of your choice. First of all, select it. Make sure you duplicate it. Change the render appearance. We have different categories here. Any category of your choice can go ahead with it. Let me pick this. You can change the height. Let's copy this same plant to this other side. To create another style from this, make a copy of it, duplicate, then change the render appearance. Let's use this. Change the height. You can use this same pattern to place other trees, just like that. Just highlight it, duplicate, and place it elsewhere. With this RPC shrub, you can get large files of libraries ranging from automobiles, trees, furnitures, even human beings. Let's add few more trees before we proceed. When you are done with it, the third step is the rendering setting. Click on this little icon that looks like a kettle. Show rendering dialog. Click on it. If you want to render a particular region, you can click here and adjust the region you want to render. You can adjust it here. This is necessary if you want to render a particular region of a large project. And here is the settings. We have the draft, the medium, the high, the best, and even the custom. The higher the rendering level, the better the quality, and the more it will take time to render. And here is the resolution. This is a screen, like a preview, but you need to change it to printer so that you can increase the DPI. Here we have 300, we have 600. You can even increase it to 900 if you want to. You can see the width and the height of this view and the size of the image, which is 13.1 MB. And this is one of the important things you should pay attention to. The scheme for the exterior. If you are using artificial lights for the exterior and you don't want the sunlight, especially for night rendering, choose artificial only. But if it is a daylight rendering, you can choose sun and artificial or sun only. Same thing for the interior. If you are rendering the interior, you can choose to use artificial only or sun and artificial or sun only. And the next setting is for sun. You can choose any of these: the still, the single day, the multi-day, and lightning. This is all for the sun, but I will leave it at lightning. I will leave the setting just like this. This is for the artificial light. You can turn on or off it. If you place artificial lights in the project, here is where you turn it on or you off it. But I don't have artificial lights in this project. That's why we don't have much in this dialog. The next thing is the background. We have no clouds, very few clouds and cloudy. And Revit skies are not that impressive. So the best thing you need to do is to import a sky. You can download a sky and import into the project. For you to do that, click on image, select the folder you save the sky. I have a few sky here. Let me use this. We have the original size, the stretch, width and height, but you need to make sure that it covers this box. So I'll stretch it to cover it. Click OK. Exposure. Here is where you adjust the brightness. I'll leave it at 13 for now. The highlight, the shadow brightness, you can increase it if you want to. The saturation, then the white point. This is the available setting. Let's render with medium and see how it looks like. Please, if you found this video helpful, don't forget to hit the subscribe button. It's completely free, and also give us a thumbs up. This is what we got. From here you can make some adjustments before the final rendering, like the brightness. Let's reduce it. Okay, I think this is okay. If you want to have a warm color, you can increase the white point. I will leave it at 7200. Apply. You've seen it. I need to change this sky. Let me pick another sky. I'll need to render it for the changes we effect. We'll go for a higher resolution so we can get a better rendering quality. So I'll use base. The higher the resolution, the better the image quality. I will use 150 dpi. Let me use base for the setting. The rendering is almost done. Elapsed time 1 hour 39 minutes 3 seconds. If I added artificial light, it will take more time. And this rendering time depends on your computer specifications. Click close. Here you can make a few adjustments before you export the rendering. Click on Adjust exposure. You can play around with it. Let me leave the exposure value at 14. The highlight, you can choose to reduce it. Just the same thing we did the previous time. After the adjustments, just click apply. And here you can reset all these values. Click here to export the rendering. Choose the folder. Here you can choose the format. Click save. And you can save the rendering to this Revit project. Click here to save to project. For you to have a better rendering quality, you need to consider exporting it to either Lumion, Enscape, Twinmotion, or Vray, any of the rendering softwares. That will save more time and give you a quality rendering. You can still enhance the image quality in Photoshop. That is for post-production. That's how you render your model in Revit. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell so you never miss future tutorials. Drop your questions in the comments and let me know what you want to learn next. Thank you for watching this video.